The hot summers in the town of Big Fork, Montana are full of tourists and lake enthusiasts. The 4th of July is a day where everyone from all over come together to celebrate in the packed streets of downtown Big Fork. After the festivities are done, almost everyone heads to the main tourist attraction, Flathead Lake, to enjoy an evening of boating and recreation. But what happens under this blue water? A predator so small and dangerous that it could possibly make all the fun of the lake go away.
You know, probably about 2007 on, I've worked for the Aquatic Invasive Species Program, so I've kind of done every job within the program, and, you know, zebra mussels have been one of our major, you know, points of concern that whole time.
The silent invader, also known as zebra mussels. They seem like nothing at first, only about the size of a fingernail, but these small predators can negatively affect our ecosystem in so many ways. They attach themselves to boat motors, trailers, pipes, and docks. They plug up drain pipes in any water flow that may leave or enter any water vessel. They spread quickly and abundantly.
So 2 years ago, we discovered a juvenile zebra mussel called a veliger in Tiber Lake. And we still have not seen any adults in that lake. So I can't really say that we found zebra mussels in Montana, but we have found a juvenile stage. And we've been testing since then and still haven't found any adults.
Because of the mass abundance of this species, they are threatening to spread throughout the states. And how are they spreading? On watercrafts like yours. Recreational activity on boats is the prime way these creatures are spreading to other parts of the country. Adult mussels attach themselves to almost anything. And attending a lake that is full of zebra mussels, it's almost certain that you will catch one of these creatures on the side of your water vessel.
The veligers, you can't see them with your eye, so they could be floating around in the water and you might not even know it. So that's why clean, drain, dry is important. If you've got water in your boat, you don't know if there's veligers floating around in that water. So that's why we say clean, drain, and dry. And mussels are just one of the things we're concerned about. There's a lot of invasive species, whether it's plants, animals, or diseases out there. And we're concerned about all of those things. So clean, drain, dry takes care of everything, whether it's a plant, animal, or a disease.
Zebra mussels are creatures that look like clams or seashells. But they are, in reality, dangerous living creatures. The outer shell is lined with black and white, like a zebra. And the inside is filled with small hairs, known as cilia, or abyssal threads. They help them attach to any surface they can. They live for 4 to 5 years, but it's the threat of multiplying that makes them so dangerous.
When zebra mussels invade a lake, pretty much what they do is they're filter feeders, so they take in the plankton that other small organisms rely on, like small fish. So it really does start a bottom-up kind of a problem, whereas the plankton in the water gets reduced and then there's not enough food for that, you know, primary production in the lake. you know, as far as getting them out of a lake, it's pretty much impossible once they become established in the lake. I mean, they survive because there's food in the water to eat, and we really haven't seen a situation where they exhaust that food supply. So, you know, once they're in a lake, it's kind of too late at that point.
Small veligers from other bodies of water can float through pools that form in other water vehicles, and they can stay there until cleaned or converted to another body of water. A single veliger can multiply into hundreds, or maybe even thousands more. Zebra mussels start as an egg and will slowly grow larger into a veliger. A veliger is a mussel larvae, almost not even visible to the human eye. One female zebra mussel can create over 1 million more microscopic mussel larvae, and those million can multiply themselves once they have reached the age to do so. Veligers hatch themselves from egg capsules and will mature to a point called competence, where they will then start to form into the juvenile stage of zebra mussel. They can form into a feeding or a non-feeding veliger. Feeding veligers will not be fully developed from the larva stage to the juvenile stage, and will be forced to feed on plankton, a source of food for other fish as well. When mussels are converted to another body of water, they will compete with the fish for this food. Non-feeding veligers don't have to rely on plankton to survive. They use the egg yolk that is stored in the eggs they hatch from as an energy source.
You know, usually what will happen is a boater will go to a lake that has a zebra mussel problem, leave the lake with either adults or just water in their boat or on their equipment, travel to a new lake. Those mussels will, you know, either fall off of the trailer or be released in the ballast water of that boat into the lake. If conditions are correct, those mussels will find each other and spawn, and then they will release, you know, what are called veligers into the water, which, like Liz said, are microscopic. You can't see them with the naked eye. And then in as little as one season, they'll settle to the bottom and become adults. And then, you know, they do the same thing over and over. And it really doesn't take long before, you know, almost the entire, you know, bottom of the lake is just covered with them.
Boaters are more than encouraged to clean, drain, and dry their boats. Boaters should visit their local inspection station, where they will clean and inspect your boat for you, and make sure there are no stowaways hiding in your vessel. It is illegal to enter another state with your water vessel when just inhabiting a different body of water. You are required to stop at a boat inspection station to keep our uninhabited lakes safe. But unlike the one in Glacier, Montana, Big Fork has no place for proper boat inspection. At Wayfarers Park, boaters are free to put their boat in at whatever time they want, and one small mistake can lead to a very big problem.
Yeah, it would definitely put a major blow to the economic, you know, industry around Flathead Lake. You know, places rely on tourists and recreators quite a bit for, you know, just that annual cash flow. And, you know, if we detected zebra mussels in Flathead Lake, there'd definitely be heightened inspections, possible closures, things like that, that would, you know, affect the tourism rate for sure. So it would not be good.
These mussels are a nuisance for fishermen and other recreational activists. In some cases, the lake is a prime part of their everyday jobs. Vendors on the lakes would be without business and may be forced to shut down due to an overabundance of this species. Aquatic recreation is the main source of income for some places and would be at a shortage of business due to the small shells. Some think it is almost inevitable for these beings to infest the Flathead in a matter of years.
You know, we like to think that our inspection stations and our early detection monitoring program can really, you know, stop the invasion. As far as people that say it's inevitable, that very well may be. However, if we can postpone it as long as possible, there may be, you know, advancements in technology that enable us to better deal with the situation once it arises.
Zebra mussels have almost no natural enemies. The closest predator to their kind are birds and fish that will often feed on the veligers and mussels attached to other objects. However, the species that do eat these beings are not present in North America, and seem to be only present in Europe. It's as if almost no predator can defeat these creatures. They can even last 7 days without water, A set of chemicals may be able to get rid of these creatures, but those same chemicals could also affect other aquatic life as well. Some wonder if adding a different species to these water will help extinguish their flame.
So wherever the zebra mussels came from, which is the Black Sea, the Caspian Sea, that's their native area. And so there are natural things that prey on them there. When they get moved to someplace new, like North America, their prey doesn't follow along. So that's why they explode in population, is because there's nothing to keep them in check here in North America. Whatever preyed on them back there isn't here. And you don't want to introduce something like that here, because we could be introducing a whole nother invasive species that could be a huge problem. So you can't bring in something that might have been its normal predator, because you could be introducing a whole nother problem. That's why, you know, once they are here and established, it's super hard to get rid of them, because there's nothing we have that wants to eat zebra mussels.
Experts are hard at work at trying to keep these creatures out of our waters, but it can all be up to you to put an end to it. Cleaning, draining, and drying your boats is how we can keep these animals away from the lakes that we love and preserve. Checking in with your local inspection station whenever coming from another lake is just another way on how we can keep our lakes clean and secure. Our conquest on keeping our lakes uninfested starts with you and can end with you as well.